Namaskar, myself Pratik. In this session, we are going to discuss part 2 of implementing simple linear regression. We will understand the need to perform train test split in this session. We will also discuss the code to perform this operation in Python. Let us start this session. In previous session, we have already imported all desired libraries. We have this data set of researcher where we have to predict the stipend on the basis of their research experience. We have loaded the data set and we have created X and Y by using iloc function. Now after loading the data set, the next step will be to split this data set into training and test set. In this data set, we have total 30 records. These 30 records will be divided into two parts. 20 samples will be considered for training purpose, while 10 samples will be considered for testing purpose. In simple words, 2/3 of data will be used for training and 1/3 of data will be used for testing. It is very important to understand the need of splitting this data set into training and testing. So instead of first splitting the data into training and test, we will first understand the need of this step. We will understand its need by considering a very basic example. Let's suppose we have a teacher. He wants to evaluate the performance of his student. Teacher has prepared a question bank of 10 questions for evaluating the performance of a student on a given topic. Now in one situation, teacher share all the questions and their corresponding keys with the student and ask them to prepare for the test. Then out of these 10 questions, teacher ask any 4 questions in the test. Now this is very natural that student will perform very well in that exam because teacher has already shared all 10 questions and their corresponding keys with the student. So there are very high chances that student will learn these questions by heart or just cram these questions. So when from this set of 10 questions, 4 questions are asked in the test, there are very high chance that student will get 100% marks or very good marks. But these high marks do not guarantee that student actually understood the concept because we have shared all the questions with their keys with the student, and from that we have just asked 4 questions in the test. In the same way, if we give the whole data set to a machine learning system to learn and then test the system from the same data set, then it will return very high accuracy, but it does not guarantee that model actually learn well. So the result may be vague. And this situation is commonly known as overfitting problem in machine learning. So in order to solve this problem or in order to test the learning in a proper way, we should have to use different strategy. So let us consider another strategy where teacher only shares 6 questions along with their key with the student. And then he uses remaining 4 questions for testing the student. Now in this case, student has to learn the concept on the basis of these 6 questions and he will be tested on another set of 4 questions. Now on the basis of performance of students on these 4 questions, teacher can actually evaluate the learning level of the student. The teacher will compare the answer written by the student with their corresponding keys, and based on that he evaluate the student. If student is able to solve all the question, teacher can say that his level of understanding is 100%. But if student is able to answer 80% question correctly, then teacher can understand that student level of understanding is 80%. So in this way, we evaluate the performance of student. Now we can apply the same concept in our machine learning model to evaluate its performance. So instead of giving the whole data set to machine learning model for its training and then testing it on the same data set will not make a sense. So we will divide the data set into two parts. One is training and another is testing. Machine learning model will be given training data to learn from its relationship. The machine learning model will build the model based on that data set. Then it will be tested on the test data. Machine learning model will make some prediction on the test data. Then that prediction will be compared with the actual results to evaluate the performance of machine learning model. To understand this concept further, let us consider this stipend data. These are not the actual content of our CSV file. We have just created some instances for understanding the concept. Here in this Excel file, you can see that we have two columns. One is stipend and another is research experience. There are total 30 records. Because index values start from 2, so there are total 30 records in this data set. Now this data set will be divided into two parts. One is training and another is testing. So we have already stored research experience in X and stipend in Y. Now we will select randomly 20 records for its training, and remaining 10 records will be used for testing. Now in order to explain this concept in a simple way, let's suppose we select first 20 records for training and last 10 records for testing. But actually these records will be selected randomly. So here I have selected first 20 records research experience as X-train. So you can see that these are the values of first 20 records research experience. So I am naming this as X-train. Their corresponding stipend value will be stored in Y-train. So this will be my Y-train. So here I have 20 records in X-train, which will have their values of research experience, and their corresponding stipend is stored in Y-train. Here first record refers to the research experience of a particular scholar. The corresponding index value in Y-train will refer its corresponding salary. Second index refers to another researcher. So this is research experience of that researcher, and this is his corresponding salary. The last 10 records we have used for testing purpose. You can see that the experience from 6.2 to 10.9 will be considered as X test. So 6.2 to 10.9, last 10 records here become our X test, and their corresponding stipend, which is from 94,944 to this last number. So these are the same records. So this is considered as Y test. You can also consider like this way also, where we have total 30 questions. These are divided into two parts. 20 questions are considered for training purpose. These are the questions, these are their keys. So we will give the question and their keys to the students for learning. We will use this 10 questions and their corresponding keys to test the student. So in the exam, we will ask these 10 questions to the student. So when student attempt these 10 questions, he will give some answer based on his or her learning. In case of machine learning, the answers given by model on X test is known as Y predict. So let's suppose for these given values of X test, machine learning model predict some values, and these values will be Y predict. Now in order to evaluate the performance of machine learning model, we will compare the value of Y predict with the Y test. Here Y test will be actual salary and Y predict will carry predicted salary. The difference between predicted and actual salary will be the error of model. So this is the way to test our model. This is very important step to understand in the beginning, because we will perform this step every time whenever we have to build a machine learning model. So we can conclude that the total data set will be divided into two part. One is training and another is testing. Here 2/3 of data will be used for training purpose. This training will be divided into Xtrain, which will carry the data of input attribute or independent attribute. Then we have Ytrain, which will carry corresponding values of dependent attribute. System learn from this Xtrain and Ytrain. The model will be built on the basis of this data. After building this model, we will test it on Xtest, which will be 1/3 of data. The system will make prediction as Ypredict. In order to measure the performance of this model, we will compare Ypredict with the Ytest. Here Ytest contain actual results. Ypredict will contain predicted values. So by comparing predicted value with the actual value, we will able to evaluate the performance of our machine learning model. Now let us perform this train test split in Python. In order to perform this step, we have to use model underscore selection library of sklearn. This library contain a method train underscore test underscore split to perform this split of data. So here we are importing train underscore test underscore split from sklearn.model_selection. So the syntax is from sklearn.model_selection. This is the name of library which is present in sklearn, and we are importing a method train underscore test underscore split. This train underscore test underscore split method require 4 parameters. You can see in this command. Here we are passing data sets as first 2 parameters. Of course, in our data set we have x and y which we want to split. So x will be split into 2 parts, that will be x underscore train and x underscore test, and y will split into 2 parts, y underscore train and y underscore test. The third parameter is to specify the test size. Here our test size is 1/3. It means 2/3 of data will be used for training and 1/3 will be used for testing. Random underscore state is equal to 0 indicate that we are selecting the records randomly. We will discuss the importance of random underscore state equal to 0 in next slide. But at this point it is important to note that the first 2 parameters refer the source of data array, and in this case it is x and y. The third parameter is test size, and in this case it is 1/3, means 10 record will be used for testing and 20 will be used for training. We are selecting the records randomly, so random underscore state should be equal to 0. Now let us understand the importance of this random underscore state. By setting random underscore state to a fixed value, it will guarantee that same sequence of random number is generated each time when you run the code. Actually, this help in verifying the output. Actually, this random state is used to specify the seed number for random number generation. By fixing this seed number, we ensure that whenever we rerun the code, same random number will be generated, or in simple words, same record will be selected in training and testing. Otherwise, during every rerun, you will get different results. So, in order to ensure that at every rerun, we get the same results, we are just fixing the seed number for random number generation. And by fixing this seed number, it will generate same sequence of random number. But when it is not fixed, it will generate different sequence of random number when we rerun the code. So this random number should be fixed to some integer value. If we set this value to none, then on every rerun of code, it will result different set of rows in our training and testing data set. It is important to note that if you fix this random underscore state to 1 or 2 or 3 or 0, it will have the same behavior. The idea is just to fix this number. You can fix it to 1, 2 or any integer number. So the same behavior will be achieved if you fixed it to any other integer value. So this is the reason that in fourth parameter we have specified random underscore state equal to 0. By executing this line of code, our x and y will split into x underscore train, x underscore test, y underscore train and y underscore test. We will execute this code in Spider in next video session. This is all about this session. Please subscribe to this YouTube channel to receive latest video tutorials on topics like data mining, machine learning, DBMS, big data, NoSQL and many more. To learn SQL in a simplified way, you can join this online course on SQL, which is available at Udemy platform. Similarly, to learn PLSQL, you can join this online course on PLSQL, which is also available at Udemy platform. I have also authored books on data mining and data warehousing, DBMS, NoSQL, beginning with SQL and PLSQL for beginners. All these books are available at Amazon platform. To read more about this, you can refer my website pratikbhatia.com. Thanks for watching this video.